Let's take a look at the atomic structure for sulfur. That's S on the periodic table. We'll also use the Bohr diagram here to help us visualize where these electrons are around the nucleus. Sulfur is atomic number 16 on the periodic table. What that means is that the atomic number, it equals the number of protons. So we have 16 protons in the nucleus of the sulfur atom here. Sulfur is also a neutral element. All of the elements on the periodic table, they're listed as neutral. Since it's neutral, the number of protons equals the number of electrons. So we have 16 protons in the nucleus, and then we're going to have 16 electrons in these energy levels here around the nucleus of the sulfur atom. Let's use the periodic table to help us visualize this. So we have 16 total electrons. We'll go to the first energy level. This is the first period on the periodic table. We have 1, 2. So the first two electrons, they go in the first energy level. But then that's full. So we need to go to the second energy level. So we go to the second energy level. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we'll put 8 in the second energy level. There's our 8 second energy level. So at this point, we have 2 plus the 8 here in the second energy level. We've used 10. We have 6 more. We go to the third energy level. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and right here, this is sulfur on the periodic table. So we put those 6 electrons in this third energy level, 2, 4, 5, 6. So that's the third energy level, and that's the highest energy level. The electrons in the highest energy level, they're called valence electrons, and they're important because they're the electrons that are involved in chemical bonding. If you need help writing the electron configuration, there's a link at the end of this video. And if you need help with neutrons, there's also a link for that too. This is Dr. B with the Bohr diagram or Bohr model for the sulfur atom. Thanks for watching.